Welcome back, everybody, here to our final game of your evening. That's right, we're kicking off the week with a whole bunch of Dota. We started early at 5 p.m. We're going to end here with our last game being No Talent going up against Absolute Legends. Of course, for StarLadder Season 4, if you haven't been watching it and actually keeping up to date with it, you can do so over at StarLadder.tv, where the boys have been hosting up all of these competitions and letting us wonderful people actually cast it. So, yeah, thanks to you guys over there. Of course, you can keep up to date with everything Dota 2 over on joindota.com. I know there's a little bit of, I'm going to say, conversation going on right now as far as the new pro rating system, which Holy Master is wanting to introduce for Join Dota. So if you want to check out what that's all about, you'll find it as a top news article over on Join Dota right now, as well as the article, which I don't know if you've heard about it, but Russia will not be going to World Cyber Games. So not only does this completely imbalance our groups, but also does change around a couple of other things as far as World Cyber Games going, because World Cyber Games only 2 weeks away now. Only 2 weeks until World Cyber Games Grand Final is going to begin, and only a couple of days away from DreamHack. So we've got some huge competitions coming up. For the guys asking for a link, just go to joindota.com. You'll find everything you want over there. it's very easy to find. Very, very easy to find. So yeah, let's look at our draft anyway. For the first time tonight, we're going to see Bounty Hunter appear. He hasn't been banned out this time around. But as of course AL are forced to ban out one of the signature heroes of the players, it is Admiral Bulldog. And looks like No Talent Hunter, they do have Loader in here. He's not playing under tag, it is Live and Let Loader. But it's in fact Loader in the S4, Aki, and Envy. Such an amazing, amazing team. I'm really looking forward to seeing how these guys go at DreamHack. I pick them for one of the top four slots if they can execute correctly. If. I say if. Oh, please. Yeah, but No Talent Hunter, they are looking absolutely amazing of late. They ban up Batrider, ban up the Darkseer, they start up with Bounty Hunter and Mag. So we already get our nice little track, big movement speed combo, and maybe going to be enough with Disruptor as well. So positional play galore. Sven, Wisp, and Rubick. Half his Sven to do much when he's completely silenced and being pulled and prodded around. And when Wisp is already picked up and you know he wants to be bringing in Rubick, Wisp gets sent back and Sven can't stay with him. You must make up your mind. Which one do you want? Because Rubick will send them all back to base. Or back to wherever they came, from whence they came. But Rubick also being selected by AL, so possible to steal that glimpse. Play the same trick against him. Radiant team ban. We go through our next stage of bans, because if we start looking at our lanes for No Talent Hunter, we've got support, we've got solo mag for middle lane, we've got Bounty Hunter off lane. So we're missing junglers, we're missing hard carry for No Talent Hunter. So already moving out, they know Sven's there, so we start off this wonderful ban against everything which could possibly bring down Sven. So Chaos Knight, Slaughter, and Nakes. Removing off all these heroes that don't use Chrono, because you already know No Talent Hunter are going to feel confident enough with Disruptor's Wall and Ulti. They're going to feel pretty confident enough that they all want to jump inside the small AoE battle and fight it out in there. So Slaughter, negative armor, Nakes, we all know what he can do. Basically outlast this Sven and just bash him to death. And then CK, good initiating stun, good instant burst damage too. And can basically disable as well as Matt can. And then you look over towards AL's lineup and you're trying to ban out against these guys and go Wisp Sven. Look for stable lanes on that one solo mid for the Rubick. So you can only take out a couple of other heroes, and that's off lanes or jungles. 5 seconds remaining. And that's it. That's of course hinging on the fact that Rubick isn't solo mid. So we see Dirge as well as Chen being removed out. So the solo junglers, if AL want to, we could look at the lines of an Enigma. I say could. As if they want to run that jungle. And that would push Rubick into the solo mid lane. But he doesn't know who he's up against just yet. So it's a dangerous thing to try and like already do your draft. You've got to wait until all five picks are out there and try and get your best matchups in between them. You can't always say, well, instantly I know exactly what I want to do as far as all my lanes go. Sometimes you do get that, and you get what's called the pocket strat. The pocket strat, knowing what you want to get before you go into it all. And Mag now being picked up, Tyler being picked up. And Lina, the return pickup from No Tyler. I like this. I like this a lot. Mag pulls them in, we've got a good AoE stun, we've got good also burst damage over that area through the Dragon Slave. And then focus fire onto one hero. And more than likely, they'll be targeted directly towards the Wisp. one last pickup from either team. Taitanta being picked up, probably meaning off lane. Thinking that no Taitanta, if they're running Bounty Hunter, could run the aggressive lane with Ven, Wisp and Rubick, but up against Disruptor and Lina, I don't like the chances of winning that. If we even get a half decent hero that can go with no Taitanta with that dual lane, you're already in trouble. But no Taitanta will want to, they're facing up against Taitanta. They will probably hope even the Taitanta goes top solo. Or would they? Bounty Hunter, leave him solo up there, run Disruptor, Lina plus one, solo, tri-lane bottom. I'm happy about that. Aggressive tri-lanes always make for good fun. So Absolute Legends, final pickup, Puck. So Bamboo's off-lane hero. Actually, sorry, that's actually mid-solo we're looking at. So Puck mid-solo. Tidehunter for this. That's a bit of a mess. Puck could always go off-lane. I'm sorry, I instantly thought of Bamboo as Puck off-lane. Now let Rubick go on the solo mid, and then Taitanta Wisp supporting. Taitanta could just grab himself a quality and blade, I don't know. Just clear off those trees in the middle lane, pull off that middle lane. Just hold and control. And the last pickup for no Taitanta. Do we go aggressive tri-lane? They would have loved the CK or the Nakes in that, but they can't take us. They have to take another cut type of hero. And almost force them to pick up a Void or an Anti-Mage. Both of which I don't think they really want to go down the path of. But Loader, decent Void player, actually. When he returned to the Dota 2 scene, Void was one of his heroes that he really started to play. If you notice, the second hit level 6, the second Void was able to, like, it's... Oh, what's the best way to describe it? Yeah, anytime he had an ultimate, he would put it back on cooldown. That's the best description. Best description. People calling out for Naga... Maybe a decent pickup, but I don't think what he wants to have happen. It will be a nice setup as far as the stun for Lina, and then Disruptor can just follow through with a little bit of extra damage. But they could also run Magnus down that bottom lane. No setup stun as such, but if you get one point up on that glimpse, then you only got that setup timing. It's going to get it right. And no Taitanta has got one more pickup to go. And their choice must be at least in 11 seconds time. 10 seconds remaining. Who can run on the aggressive tri lane? Do we see something different? Something unusual? Or is it going to be something stable like an Anti-Mage up on the solo? 1 second, 0 seconds, and Faceless Void it is. It can still work in the combination, and Void, it will be played by Loader. So they are going to go with the standard. The question is, will they go with the standard up against this event? Run the aggressive lane, let Bounty Hunter up on the top lane, or they throw Bounty Hunter to the wolves on the bottom lane? Emerald Bulldog will be the one taking the mag, so he is going to go solo. Emerald Bulldog always the offlane solo for no Taitanta, which puts S4 as the Bounty Hunter. Nah, Admiral Bulldog. He's still solo, but just different lane. It's middle lane. Where Bounty Hunter, or maybe they can switch it around. Let Bounty go up against Freezer as that Taitanta. Bamboo is going to take up the puck. The Bamboo's been running that puck in the mid lane. Which lets the other lanes just switch themselves around. Actually, no, there's the swap over. Seen the switch. Bamboo over to the Taitanta. Yep. Picked up the puck to start with, and then the team is like, wait, whoa, yeah. And then no time to do the same. S4 moves over to the mag. And that makes sense. So Admiral Bulldog, he gets the offlane solo. We've got three of them already heading up towards the top. Loader is the Faceless Void. Put up in a whole bunch of rocks on the head. But Admiral Bulldog, poor man's shield, already going to be looking to be an absolute nuisance on that bottom lane. So be safe, farm for the Void on the top. S4 going bottle build, so he'll head in towards the middle lane for the solo. Eternal Envy and Aki, the two supporters. Coming out with the wards and consumables, just to make sure that jungle is protected. Mani will be the support Rubick for Absolute Legends up towards the top. It's going to be Freezer going offlane, Puck, solo, Bamboo. Solo mid, but not as Puck, as Tidehunter. He's expecting the melee to arrive in the mid. To which point, he is actually correct. But the damage that's done by S4 is for farm. Sure, it can come from his right clicks, but most of the time, if he's desperate enough to do it, gets that bottle up nice and early and gets a shockwave, uses the shockwave to farm. And that damage is thrown into the Tidehunter. Not that the tide's going to care too much. You've got a large portion of life and scales very, very nicely for that. So we've got Ice with me. Come with me on the bottom lane for Absolute Legends. And he'll be combining up with Sony. So Sony, the big farmer, is Ven. Let's start off the game. The creep waves are spawned out, so we're going to officially start this one off, and all the boys get to show each other on the lanes. And live and let Loda, live and let him farm on the top lane. That's all he wants. Just farm. Just give him farm, and he's a happy chappy. And Puck, I really don't see him having a good time. Drops down the ward, instantly sees Aki. Wants to know what's happening behind everything. Not a big depth of vision, but the fact that it comes up to here, and as well as up to here. See those moments where Aki just starts to rotate around? And he's going to come and he's going to sentry ward it. Yeah, he ward it. Absolute dick. No vision for Puck. He may as well just let it go. Bamboo, he's going to have a hard time here in the middle lane. Like, you can't anchor smash all the time. Then again, S4 can't shockwave all the time. So, at the end of the day, Bamboo is probably going to enjoy this lane a lot more than S4, actually. And both trying to rush up that bottle. Then Bamboo can spam out everything, look for rune control. Admiral Bulldog forced back in the bottom lane. Got no sentry wards here apart from what's on Wisp. He hasn't planted them down just yet. Trying to almost force come with me to do that as he clears off even more trees. Plant a sentry ward, smack bang here. See a little bit off to the side of the lane as well as into the jungle area. Nice little vision for all. But there's no way Bounty Hunter's really going to stop Sony from farming. He's already up at 7 for 2. But at the same time, Void's also the same. Looking at Freezer. Got time lock and backtrack up. He's had managed to backtrack. Oh, there we go. There's the first backtrack I've seen. And Freezer going to pause the game. I'm going to be lagging up a little bit. That's Eternal Envy. What was he doing down here? Okay, so that's a sentry ward stopping the ancient stack. That's something I think Mania was here trying to help Bamboo with. Stack this little guy up and then bring Sven up. That's once it's got Mask of Madness. So they're assuming that Sony's able to get a large amount of farm to get that Mask of Madness very early on. Or else they wouldn't be stacking this early. Well, I suppose they could be. Well, let's wait for the sentry ward to die out. Freezer, you're a long way from home, man. Disruptor, no glimpse. He's got Thunderstrike, though. That's going to be a lot of damage. Can't phase shift out of that one. Keep the right clicks flying. One more pulse. 115 life points and pops off the salve. And while Eternal Envy will chase him and he might waste a little bit of his own time, it's Freezer who has to waste even more time trying to get back. Yep, there's the courier diverting its own path. There's a hazard on the deck. Freezer can't catch it. Now, he's wasting a lot of time transitioning around. Void's got all the space in the world. In fact, I think Void and Aki think about doing some damage towards this tower. And now Admiral Bulldog comes up. Bottom lane, well, I can't do anything on the lane, so I may as well try and attack Freezer. And he's doing it pretty damn successfully. Freezer's got to orb away from this. Invis is already happening. Mania's going to come in, kind of waiting for Admiral Bulldog to make his move, and Freezer finds himself an Invis rune. Lucky devil. And S4 is also here. Now going to go on Mania. Comes out the Ghost Walk, nice amount of damage. Puck, got to help him out, throwing Admiral Bulldog up towards the high ground, exactly where he wants to be. So Mania has to stay on the low ground, shockwave through. First blood spilled by S4. And Freezer still inside that Invis. Sentry will throw it down. They're going to see Admiral Bulldog. There he goes out first stun. Tether's there. Tether running through Admiral Bulldog. Secondary ward has to be planted down. And they get the revenge kill. Very quick rotation there from Absolute Legends. Coming off that bottom lane, but at the same time, top lane. The tower goes down. Loda claiming, I believe, the last tin on that one. No tower to destroy by the dinosaurs. Shared around everybody. But they just keep pushing. Find the levels. 4.5 now up on Void. As far as trades go, no Tunnel will be happy as Larry. I don't know how happy Larry is, really. I don't know if we've got a guy tuning in. Shout out to all the Larrys currently watching the live stream. S4. Almost arcane boots up for him. So I'm even going the bottle. I kind of like this, too. It's just spam shockwave. That's all he wants. Get the bonus mana. And just spam the shockwave out. Increase his mana pool as well so we can use his proper combo. Spam that little guy here up a reverse polarity. You can see 200 mana for the first level. And without the mana boost, he doesn't have what he needs. And that courier went rather close. Actually, no, he buys treads and bottles. So, there goes that idea out the window. Admiral Bulldog saving him the haste rune. So West Falls now got that little sucker. And Bamboo returns towards the middle. And S4 switching to Intel Trez. Now he's got the mana pool that he can't still do a full combo. 90, 80 plus the 200. You can do the math on that one and you'll get yourself up to 370. And there's a haste rune popping. Trying to come down for Come With Me. Quick run and Come With Me. A long way out of position. Too much damage. Can't tether yourself out to Mania for that. And Mania, because he came in close, now he's got to deal with S4. We might just run in front of him and then skewer him back. A lot of damage already being done, and S4, yeah, there's a skewer in, and shockwave, and right click. Double kill for S4. Easy chain off, and now we're looking for the top lane. Void, oh, I thought he might be level 6 by now, but he's not. And Aki getting that stun out in the phase-shifting puck. Not the easy, oh, wait, no, it's not even a phase-shifting puck. Didn't even realize how much Frieza has knocked up that long walk around the ballpark. That really hurt him a lot more than what I originally thought. He hasn't got even level 2 yet. So Envy coming in, glimpsing him back, throwing him in the wall. He's got no mana for an orb. Luckily for him, he got that level 2 then, so he's able to phase shift out a little bit. But Loader jumps in with one more right click. That's going to be his level, oh, not level 6 just yet. Sony holding Loader, no backtrack on that. Aki's done a little bit too slow. And maybe a double kill for him. Support's coming in from the side. Bamboo, Gosh, Anchor Smash kill. But he gives it to Sven instead. So double kill for Sony. Good time to TP out and run away. And Wisp just trying to soak up some form of experience up against the Bounty Hunter on the bottom lane. But first thing to go right for Absolute Legends. And you can see things going wrong. Moving down to that 3,000 advantage in favor of No Tide. So for 1,000 worth of experience from that last little fight in the top. And S4 having to deal with Tidehunter, who's at level 6. So ganking him is almost impossible. Unless they can keep him chain locked. And I'm looking at you, Void. And Loader. In fact, you know, skip his ultimate. Doesn't want it. Extra points in backtrack, time lock. And then one in the jump, but that's still 5. Do the math on that one. That's only 5 points. There we go. Doesn't skip the ultimate. And Frieza stacking for his... Oh, one ancient black dragon spoils it all. With the TP of Bamboo now returning. Sven with those 2 kills. Building up drums to start with, and then we'll go into the what I hope to be Mask of Madness. It's the only reason why we'll be stacking that much. Oh, and that's my only reason. We can just tank up the damage and then go back and heal. But not the best way to, not the best way to farm. Not efficiently. S4 with a double damage rune. Pops the bottle charge, so he's got the mana pool up his sleeve. Because he's basically got skewer reverse polarity and he's out. The problem of having such a low mana pool, switching to Intel Trade's going to help him out. But the call's being done by Wisp. Can I come back? I'm hearing a little bit of fun up on the top. Oh, it's just Frieza. 4 CS in this game and not even level 3 yet. And we're almost 8 minutes in. He's being out leveled by Lina. Was part of the tri-lane. And there's your bottom lane gank. So Sven, nice double stun, but not able to escape. Getting killed by the creep wave, actually. Not by one of the heroes. Killed by the creep wave. I don't think we also saw track off at that time. Hello, Lina. Or goodbye, Lina. No ulti. Wisp doesn't have it just yet. So it's just a standard four-man gank coming in. And Lina thought she could stand on the middle lane by herself, probably trying to soak up that level 6. Whoop, she's gone bold. Extra support is coming in from S4. He's got himself a regen rune, which you won't want to pop off just yet. One quick shockwave, going to go through Bamboo and Frieza. He'll have himself another one in a couple of moments' time, but nope, overpower to start with. And Radiant side, very, very wisely falling back out again. Yep, there's our last hit. And now regen will pop. Slowly building his way up. One last shockwave. Yeah, one last shockwave, and still gets the regen rune effect at the end of it. A little of extra damage he gets to the creep wave, but pushes that a little bit further as well. Had a minus from Loader. Treads now fully done. So easy, easy farm for Loader. What's his gold per minute now sitting at? 462. And 404 coming out for the mag. Closest to them is going to be Sven. He's finished up his drums and treads. Pick up a TP scroll, because he's going to need to be there when these engagements begin. And that, they just leave him on that bottom lane. Say, Sony, you know what, man? Just keep farming, man. Just keep farming. Don't stop. Just keep going. Poor Freezer. At least he's hit level 4 now. But Lina needs to be involved in a kill before he's going to hit level 6. Bottom tower is under attack. Things coming out everywhere across the map. Admiral Bulldog searching on the top lane for a kill. Wish doesn't come. Boy just wanted the setup and the track. And we start with the Ancient Stack again. This time it will spawn. So that's really good farm there for Sven if he wants it. But it means he's still got to rotate up that bottom lane. It means he also needs lifesteal and a faster attack speed. Can use the God Strength to do it. But really needs to combine that up with the Mask of Madness. That's what the Ancient Stack's all about. Freeze is just making sure his hard carry gets even harder in carry. At the same time, he's going to be really cautious about no Tunner spotting it out. They have their own ward looking for that. At this point, their only ward they've got is on the low ground. And they need to get it up on this high ground up here. And Bamboo can always make your life a living hell. Haven't seen a single Ravage pop off just yet, because there hasn't really been a moment for it. And, whoop, hello. Mag Illusion. Even that's trying to kill off Freezer and almost being not being successful, but doing a decent amount of damage. But spots the Ancient Stack. So they know what's going on, and now Admiral Bulldog chasing down Freezer. Forced to orb and phase shift himself away. Is under attack. Off with you. And the TP back down towards the bottom lane. God offended. Admiral Bulldog's been gone for a while. Just been moving around looking for a hunt, but couldn't find something. And because of that, little extra farm comes the way of Sven. Now Tether, move in. 3,000 experience, gotta look for that stun. Sentry ward drops down, so Bulldog unable to hide anywhere. And Sony even popped off the God Strength for that one. Push back in there, get the tower, man. Don't waste your God Strength. Unless they're gonna tether an ulti somewhere, which they're about to. Gonna assume gonna be brought in towards that middle lane, cause Bamboo got a Ravage right now. There's three heroes, there she pops, Anchor Smash already been done. Aki just disintegrates the Rubick with the ultimate, and Void jumps in, looking for Bamboo. The toss goes through, they're gonna take the T1 tower, the Chrono will drop, Loader on such low life. And it was Wisp who TP'd in, and Bamboo will live through this for the moment. Eternal Envy trying to try and finish him off. Can they finish it? Tied by a Split Dagger, what? Envy's out of mana. Envy's out of everything. He couldn't finish the job. And Sony, look at that speed. Look at him run. It's cool runnings. And a quick, easy kill. And then very, very fast TP out before Bulldog's capable of Shuri tossing him. So I guess the snipe off kill on the run out. But Wiz TP'd in there with ultimate and then instantly got himself into even more trouble. Good thing for him is ultimate pulled him back out again. Bamboo almost level 11 now. Oh, that Blink Dagger up really nice and fast. He used the Ravage during the last engagement, so he's got himself another 70 seconds before he'll... Oh, 80. Before he'll have it back again. We would like to push down that T1 tower, finally. There's that Mask of Mass we're looking for from Sony. So it comes in, and Farm McFarm Farm. Already that gold per minute just skyrocketing up to over 550. Top in the Void. He also has his own Mask of Madness and running that Hand of Midas. We see the BKB starting off from Sven. So Mithril Hammer to start with, looking for that bonus damage. So BKB and then into what would normally be crit. So Crystallis. I've seen some players start off with the Ogre Club and then go into the Crystallis, then finish the BKB, then finish the Daedalus. Wow, they even got in this stack. Damage, 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 damage. Sony gets the farm. Where are you going? Where are you going? Up towards the top lane. That wasn't intentional. I think he wants to pull Bamboo out of this one. Yeah, that definitely wasn't intentional. In fact, he got glimpsed back in again. And then gets returned back to his normal position. I think he was originally going to bring in Sven with him. Sven was running up towards that top lane to help out. But didn't go the way he intended. Warcry, stun, gonna hit on Aki. Wow, didn't we just see this before in the middle lane before? It's gonna happen again. Void, nice Chrono, gonna focus on Wisp, but then again, Wisp able to tank up a little bit more. Now Chrono stolen by Mania, holding Bulldog in position. Puck Goldie also threw out the stun, trying to go through Loader. There's Ven stun, gets it right. Now gonna move back down again. Mania's in a little bit of trouble. Admiral Bulldog running around with him, freezing in the middle of this mix. Roshan being aggroed out. Ravaged a pop by Bamboo. Three heroes caught. Anchor smash well. Double kill for Sony. Now on to S4. And they both get pulled back by the skewer. But Sony instantly back after with the Storm Bolt. Pops off the God Strength just so he can polish up this tier 1 tower in the middle lane as well. And with kill after kill after kill, he is now only 100. Make that 20 gold away from having a full BKB. And that's the selling of maybe one of his Ironwood branches. And that's fine. But pushing up towards the top lane. All right, he's gonna head down. Thought they might just instantly just push out that top. He's out of mana. He's out of life. Let's go back and regenerate. But full BKB. 15 minutes in with Mask of Madness for Sven, who hasn't had the best start, but no Talanta. Made sure he got more after that point. Came out, got the double ancient stack, a little bit of an easy stack as well inside the jungle. Smoke gang time now from Rotard Hunter. Looking for that kill. Blink Dagger's up on Mag, so they've got the positional play to go with. Or are they looking to just jump inside for Roshan? Oh, that ward vision. It's limited to here, and they've all walked on the edge of it, so the smoke not revealing out. Nope. Hit the mute button before the sneeze. Woo! That was close. But this is a really smart smoke. In they go, and they're going to tank this out. Roshan, the call is being done by Bamboo. Something's going on. They're de-warding at this point. Then the blink in. Bamboo! Roshan killed by the Dire. And Sven's going to make his move in as well. The Chronosphere is locked in. 3 of AL. Sony will go down too. Puck comes in to drop the ultimate. But instantly has to jump back. Ash, he got glimpsed. He got dropped out. And S4 will chase him. Oh, we got a steal from Mania. Ended up stealing his own little run, and that got him in range to pull back. Fade Bolt not needing damage. Right click from Puck gets the kill. So they get a little bit back out of that one. Oh, but Ty blindly blinking into the Rosh pit. Bamboo with balls of steel. Did not work for him in the end. And the gem being swiped out. That's exactly what it... No, he didn't even buy that at the start. Man, that's just one of those moments, man. One of those moments you jump in and Void's just like, So, 3 in Chrono. Okay. Easily done. I'm not pulling in my whole team in that either. And then Puck decided to jump into the middle of it too. Ah, Loader, he's feeling really defensive. Possibly because this is happening on the top lane. It's another 11 seconds before Ice, come with me, we'll have his ulti. And Bamboo's searching for something. This Mag just needs to pause. Scratch that nose of his. That could just be exactly it. Marley's running out in the bottom lane. I just need a moment, guys. Just need a moment. Well, scratch the nose. Okay, now I can look at my screen again. And the ancient stacks out again from Freezer. Did he get it in time? Yeah, he did. So tier 1 tower can push out the tier 2 tower as well. That BKB, full 10 second one for Sony. Never got to pop it in that last engagement. Just got locked. Dire structures are fortified. And that's where people look for the counter to Sven coming through the Faceless Void. It's the ability to hold him in position. You can't do anything when you're stuck there. Bamboo blinks up looking for a gush, but Mag fastly blinking himself away. Bamboo, wow, he got the gush. Follow up on the blink. Pull up. It's not going to pull him back up towards the high ground if he wants to. The Ravage could have happened, but very, very quick charge. S4 even finds himself a regen in the bottle. Everything's coming up roses. But didn't bring down the tier 1 tower. It's not full roses. And Sony continues to farm up in that middle lane. Almost 600 gold per minute. Just being supported so well by his teammates. Ancient stack again. Ward is a little bit too late there by Envy. He did throw it down. But Sony could start off on this one. And they realize too, for actually no, there's no radium ward. So they don't realize that's there. They won't realize until they stack again. And West to tether with Sony, so we're gonna go hunting inside that jungle or push tier two. The ping's already come for that tier two tower in the middle lane, but no, the line's been drawn. Coming out from our Rubik boy Mania saying, guys, tier two top lane. Let's go, huh? Force him down, bamboos. I don't think he wants a bar of it. I think he's expecting No Tunner to all be here looking to defend, but No Tunner are not there. Not going to come in time either. Bottom tower trying to be brought down by S4. Fortification slowing that one down. Bamboo tanks up the Dragon Slave. There's a jump in by Void. And Bamboo has to walk on the edge, but pick up. There's a blink in. Nice Ravage. S4 pulls everyone in as well. They're all held inside Envy's Ultimate. Latrak stun. Oh, sorry, Lee stun. Almost enough to hold everyone there. And Sony standing like a man with his BKB gets a double kill. Void's Aegis the Immortal jumps up. He really wants this kill on Sven, but cannot catch him with the Warcry. In the meantime, Lota's the only one left alive for his squad. Turns around to try and fight, gets a bash on Frieza. There's a stun out by Sven. And on the run, move around the trees, juke him out. Lota says, I'm pretty sure there were two heroes right here before. But they ran down south, and then the pings from Pink. It's like, they're TPing out there, man. It's like, nope, they ran down south. They juked around a tree, man. And Void back to farming. I love this little build as well from Lota. Most Faceless Voids would go up with a Battle Fury, so they can farm that way. Instead, Maelstrom into Mjolnir. Still lets him farm, because get that Chain Lightning effect that flies out, but it works. Blink Dagger, another key item to come out. Sven Armlet for him. So Armlet, Mask of Madness, and then BKB. Looking to feel really, really good. And more farm. So he had 49 at the start of this. And at the end of it, 1,100 gold he just gained from that stack in the space of a couple of seconds. Easy farm. Whoop, we're TPing somewhere. Oh, again! Wisp! You've got to keep the tether. Bamboo's trying to chase down S4. Should be decently successful at it. Warcry going to fly. Tether's already there, and Bamboo pulled out. At the same time, Sony's just like, wait, team, where's my team? Okay, I'm by myself on the wrong side of the river. Come with me, just having a couple of those moments when things don't go right. Bamboo wants to deward that, but he doesn't want to go up towards the high ground. So coming in and tether in to finish the job. They started that before West took them all back. Now Sony, Warcry, runs up through the top. Lota fast underfoot. And Sony won't catch him. Searching in the corners, and Sony blocks himself in. But it's Lota who's already out. Down the bottom lane. Farming up Mork, now buy his Hypersona if he wants it. Because this is also another nice little boost up. With the Battle Fury, you get cleave damage, but with the Mjolnir, you get a lot more attack speed. Because you're combining up with the Hyperstone and the damage you've got, and then you'll have your chance to chain, which is 25%. It's only 120 damage on that chain, but it's still chain damage. The side buys TP scroll instead, so we'll wait until they can finish up the full Mjolnir. And just wants to solo this bottom tower. Maybe not going to be enough. Sony runs up. It's like, what? Lota's still going for this? Tier 1 tower brought down. Lota can pop the Chrono and catch both of them off if he doesn't die straight away, but he dies straight away. Sony fast with that armlet. Huge damage coming out with the Mask of Madness. Gives you an insane rate. And if they find this ancient stack, I think No Tunner are going to be absolutely pissing themselves about this. Admiral Bulldog on the run. In they come. Gem on Sexy Bamboo. And there's a pull in. Wonderful play by S4. Everyone's in. Envy follows up with his ulti. Now the Void Chrono. He wants to try and bring someone down. Luna focuses on one. There goes Mania. Everyone's dead bar Bamboo. Best initiation ever from the mag. S4 got it right. Envy locked him in. Big silence from him. Locking them all in position. And Naki focuses one. So Void can focus the other. A little bit of miscommunication about who was going for what straight away. But still, big Chrono, big position. Cost them. Cost them a buyback. In fact, two buybacks from both Bounty as well as Void. Probably the reason why AL thought they could jump themselves into that fight. And now No Tunner will take the tier 1 tower in the middle lane. Radiant's middle tower has fallen. Dire's top tower is Admiral Bulldog will take care of the rest of those little creeps and head down towards bottom. Nope. I might even see a gank up on Puck. Just keep with that track, keep with the kills. Not gonna happen. Loader goes back up to farm up this ancient little stack they had going. And now, Wisp TP's in. They're looking to take this one. Bounty Hunter is the one they want, but they don't have gems. The Tired. Tired Hunter for the gem. But they kill the Void. Easy snipe off. They knew it had to happen at some point. They had the ward that saw him jump. And that was the reason why. So smart ganking coming out here from Absolute Legends. And with Void going down, doesn't make that really worth it. But he spent a lot of his cash before he died. Full BKB. And then drums for Aki. But full BKB. Straight by for Faceless Void. Does not want to be interrupted at all. So he's still going to be happy with that kill. And they should be able to take the tier 2 tower as well. It's going to be wild for Void's getting it back up again. 17 seconds is more than enough time to force out this tier 2 tower. Fortification is there. But I doubt they can stop it. Fortification. It's just stalling up the effectiveness of... Actually, no, God Strength's still on cooldown. It's just him running in with Armlet and Mask of Madness. And the tower's gone. No, Tai can't defend this, and Bamboo. Yeah, the pings are coming out from Disruptor. It's like, do you know the Bamboo is right here? And now S4 searching out with the Invis rune. There's the Gush. Track on Bamboo, keeping very, very close tabs on him. Mag now pulling in one. Finds Bamboo and lost Sony halfway through that. Then the Ravage will pop. And just Sony, he's caught inside. Bamboo going to get Laguna Bladed down. Sony locked in position as well. Puck Goldman doing what it can. Lina did take a fall during that one. Buyback out by Sven, trying to return towards the engagement. Had to TP to the tier 2 tower. He's not going to get there in time. Puck, phase shift. Blink. Up and being tracked. Can't open time. Bound down against the last right click in, and now Sven, who bought back. They were hunting. The Dire Ward's watching him so closely, maybe they doesn't want it. Roshan comes back up again. Loader can snipe that. The ping has got to come, he's got to go. By himself, he can solo up Roshan. As if he jumps in, he's got to realize that Roshan's up now. All the players always mark the time. And when Roshan goes down last, Sony blinking, jumps, Envy, four hits. And Admiral Bulldog is also here, already got the track up. So we can keep that movement speed going. Someone's trying to catch up as well, S4. He's not gonna get there in time. Even with the blink, he wanted that so he could pull the Sven back again. Blink in front, then skewer back, but he'd have to use both those abilities to try and catch up. That's only just way too fast. And that's just Warcry. Warcry and Blink Dagger. Easy jumping, easy damage, easy kills. And now the ping comes out for Roshan finally. It's like, we should go this, guys. We should go this. Well, maybe all they're waiting for is Void Chrono, but he needs a little bit of extra... Well, actually, he needs an item slot. That's what he needs. He buys Crystal as his next one. He's got two incomplete items. Might the Chrysalis as well as that Mjolnir. Wisp. Tether, he's gonna pull Puck out with him. Out. Yep, and Puck says no! Come with me being a bit of a dick. Trying to pull his teammates against their will. It's like, so far, man, your ulties haven't been that impressed with them, so maybe I'm not gonna do this. Smoke move in again by No Tadunter. Way to jump in. Loader just leaps himself in. You gotta know what's happening. Looking to solo up Roshan. Parkour, is it going to fall short? Yeah, it's a little bit short. Don't think they actually caught the... Oh, no, they caught the vision in. They know what's going on. They've also got their own little sentry ward here. They're seen just at the edge of the pit. And they're now Tide Illusion first one to go in. Freezer, silence, load up, BKB instantly. Boy, Chrono, he wants Sven. The target is there, S4, he's in the wrong position. They got ravaged up for a moment, but Sven almost dead. Not dead, however, they didn't finish the job. There's a pull back in again. Bamboo and Sony, they've got to finish off the damn Sven before he turns and does that! Loader is gone! Jump up! Sony now onto S4. Way too much damage to deal with. Buyback by Mag. Admiral Bulldog right behind Sony, but stunned. Double kill now for him. He does go down. No buyback instantly, but they're searching for Admiral Bulldog. That gem is still... Actually, no, it's not on Bamboo. We have a gem at all. We've got Dust, we've got Yules, we've got Sentries, but... Nothing's been thrown down just yet. Shockwave by S4 just trying to be a bit of a pain in the ass. And Puck with the silence. Whoop, when we get stolen. Ended up getting the shockwave out. So double nukage in the line for Mania. Well, they want to get back into the Roche armpit. Admiral Bulldog, we don't want to let them do so. Track is still on Wisp. They know exactly what's happening with Wisp. Middle lane, Puck. Freezer can't overcommit to this one, but having that Yule Sept is giving it a little bit more confidence to be over-aggressive. I love Tide Under 2. We've got Refresher Orb coming up for Bamboo. Looking for a double Ravage. Mania. Pick it. No. My sentry! And now Bamboo's track. Bulldog just hunting wherever he could find it. And he's bought enough time for Void to come back to life again. And Lotus coming in. There's the buyback by Rubick. Sven's already up. I'm here in ulti. It's Sony making his way in. BKB will pop. He wants Bulldog. Gonna right click him down faster. Kaomi's gonna sever this tether. Or maybe not. Stun goes out. Blink on down. They get the kill. Puck comes in too. Don't take him out. Freezer needs help. Damn it. Sony goes all the way back to base. And it buys the time for Loda to finish off Roshan, unless Ty gets in there right now, but he's got no Ravage. He can't stop this. Blind Blink can happen again. Bamboo wants in. Loda takes Roshan and the Aegis the Immortal. They're going to fight up against all of this again. And he's got Chrono looking for Bamboo. Gush to happen. Wisp Spirits fly through. Freezer hoping for an ultimate. But no Tide Under. They're not sure about this just yet. There is S4. Four locked in. Then the Chrono. Nobody bar Mania remains outside. Triple kill, ultra kill, why not go it? Full on rampage, SR rampage for Loda. And absolute legends are about to have their pigsty in the middle lane turned upside down by a Void with no mercy for Rax. Fortification will stall this up a little bit, but that is all. Buyback is available for Sven, but he can do absolutely nothing else. This is Minrax. This is just that moment that gave Loda the Aegis of the Immortal. One pullout can change it all. Sven had to walk back out there, and he was way too late to get back into the engagement. And no Tyler will snipe off the Rax, but they will not call the GG. That was a huge fight for no Tidehunter. Now 8.5 experience, 8.5 gold. That's everything flying their way. And Bamboo caught out, glimpsing him back a little bit. I think they hoped it was going to send him that direction, but it didn't. And Bamboo wants to stick around. He wants Envy. Envy? Oh, Envy! Almost locking himself inside the trees. Bamboo, Gush, Blink, Anchor, and he'll get the solo kill. Bounty, I didn't want to stick around and help him out. Don't see a reason to. The fact that they won that huge ass fight and didn't even lose the Aegis. Loda's still walking around with the Aegis on him. Now he's going to buy up his full. Is it actually? Yeah, full Daedalus and Mjolnir. Recipe's on the courier, but he still needs the Hyperstone. So Daedalus will finish first. Maybe even just save enough money. He's got Aegis the Immortal, who cares? Doesn't get reclaimed for another 4 minutes. Got all the time in the world. He's gonna send that courier down because only two more creep camps and he'll have his 2100. Or maybe even just the middle lane. Courier's just spending some time back at base where it's safe and warm. Plink Dagger plus the mech. Do we see the Refresher Orb yet? No, because Bamboo, of course, he had to buy back. Lost way too much cash. Couldn't finish up his Orchid. And now they're looking at Loda. There's a lot of men down here. And come with me. Oh, the tether is severed. And Loda's coming down. They see, just spotted Mania. But then again, there is a lot of cavalry just around the corner. And this could be the worst fight ever taken by AL. They will walk out into the middle. There's the tether. None wonderful ravage from AL, but then Loader, this is his power. Bash, 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 bash. Sony goes down. Freezer to follow. Walk on through. On the come with me. And then goes down over the sidelines. Bamboo needs to get in close range. And it is going to be an ultra. Nope. Admiral Bulldog will take it. Mania will TP about to safety. No stun. Nothing's going to stop him. And Glimpse not in time from Envy. And Sony comes back down towards the bottom lane. He bought back again out of pure hope that he would make it to his teammates in time. The more buybacks for the Sven. And this will be... What, really? He could have Disruptor. Cheeky little devil. Sony swipes the gem and runs away. Is he even going to farm up the Ancients? Yeah. When in Rome, lose your tier 2 tower. So the push to come. Tier 2, possible tier 3. Loader again, still not dropping that Aegis model. How long have we got before it's reclaimed? 1 minute and a half. Not a lot of time. But Loader will still want to use it. Four Mjolnirs on him. And 2.6k gold now. What is his kill count? 14 for 5. Ben's been having a great game. 17 for 7. But everyone else just not keeping up with him. 0 for 9 for the Rubick. 2 for 7, even though he has 17 assists for the Wisp. He's a level 16 Wisp, just looking to take anybody to their death. And Bamboo will never get that refresher. Now no Titan looking to push out through that bottom lane. The Empower. That's all S4 needs to put on the Loader. And then there's no need for Battle Fury. His cleave's already too powerful. Loader gets hit by Whispers, but doesn't care. Just keeps bashing down the tier 3 tower. Taking it like balls. Gushed up a little bit. Still starting to care a little bit, but not a lot. He can pop that Mjolnir if he needs it. Freezer will send him up. Silence, track, still manages to hit. More Whisper is going to go through Loader, but he takes down the tower. Now forces the Rax and is at no peril to any of his other teammates. Stunned, Aegis Immortal will pop. But it was going to be reclaimed anyway. Yep, it only had maybe another 10 seconds on it. So now Loader falls back a little bit more. So they force the Aegis out. And then he retreats. Tower went down, creep wave's gone as well. Maybe hoping someone else is going to come at them, but the mid tower's pushed, the mid lane's pushed in. I know, Tunnel, they got 4 minutes before the next Roshan. Are we going to look at another big item before that point? Admiral Bulldog already starting to build up on his heart. Something's flying, and I think Mag to spend some cash. In fact, the heart recipe is already on the courier. So Admiral Bulldog is a lot closer than what I thought. Get that Reaver, and he's basically there. But Loader giving him nothing. Taking all the cash for himself. Now up to 3.8k. Worth up on Loader. Might sell that Mask of Madness by himself. I don't know if he still wants the lifesteal Satanic. But he wants to attack fast, and that's where Mask of Madness still is just gonna be that critical thing. But at this point, TPing back to base is the most important thing. So maybe even get rid of that TP scroll after a while. Force that bottom lane. Easy enough to do. Loader. He's going to need a new charge. Come on, S4. Get over there. Empower him. Empower him in the ways of, like, Cleave. And there we go. New Empower. So, Loader. Not everyone's here. Where is... Well, Wisp and Sven. They're a long way out. Reaver on Sven, however, so we might have enough life points to survive this engagement and really fight it out. But they're trying to walk back and not use that Wisp ulti. Not trusting it at all. Clean up the middle lane. Faibot going through the bottom. AL are doing a good job of stalling off. I know Tana just wants them to come out to them. That's what they would like to have happen. Either that, they stay inside their base forever until, well, maybe for the next two and a half minutes. And then Roshan. And then Aegis and Cheese. And then unstoppable push against Absolute Legends. I say unstoppable, but anything is doable. If you get yourself a good silence, Bamboo gets himself a good Ravage. depending on what Rubik's capable of stealing as well. And then just space for Sony to hit. He can't get locked inside that Void Chrono. Can't emphasize just how important it is that Loader gets that Chrono on the Sven. He is the primary target. They bring down Sven, this fight is over. So it all comes down to whoever kills Sven, give them a gold medal, give them a prize, give them something. Because he is the critical man when it comes to Absolute Legends lineup. If he lives through these engagements, and he lives through that Chrono, I don't know how they're going to go with a man-up fight. But with the bonus damage that comes out from Sven through his God Strength, it should be enough to bring down the Void, as long as he doesn't backtrack too much. Just trying to get control of these lanes back out again. They've got to get back towards the middle lane. The lane's pushing it out. Someone's got a TP back. In fact, blinking Sony already on his way. Oh, hello, double damage. And Heaven's Halberd being started off from S4. Double damage going to be stolen by Bulldog. His full heart is now done. They can't make up their mind. It's like, do I? Don't I? Do I? Don't I? Do I? Don't I? Do I? Lost me, DD. That's me, not DD. That's going to be for Loader. Babysit him in. And he's going to use a bottle charge, grab up the DD rune, pop it off, and then give it back over to S4. And at this point, he's carrying his TP, and this is only for Roshan. This is going to be one hell of a fast Roshan. And AL, they've got to move now. Smoke to happen. They will have a grand total of maybe 5 seconds. Once the initiation starts on Roshan, once Loader jumps in there, I give it 5 seconds with that double damage. Especially now that he... Oh, man. Full butterfly for Loader before this fight's going to begin. Park Orb's checking for it. Bounty Hunter's in the neighborhood. Sentry Ward's out from the Radiant side. They're not running the gem this time. But Bamboo's straight up. They find Aki, but quick blink. Very quick blink from Aki. Sony tried to blink in as well and get that stun off. But unable to do so. Both blinks go on cooldown for a moment, but they'll be okay. There is actually a gem. Wisp was carrying a gem. So they do have some kind of vision if Bulldog wants to walk into them. But now AL have the high ground advantage. Everyone's rotated in, and there's Loader. So it starts. Puck Orb scouts it out. They know what's going on. So it's either jump in and win or just fail galore. Bamboo waiting for the time. Loader, BKB's up. Bamboo snatches the Aegis Immortal. He's going to lose his life, but at least doesn't give it to Loader. Bulldog pops his BKB as well. Ravage on cooldown and Bamboo, 4 hits to kill him. It's 3 so far and there's a 4th. Bounty Hunter will take him. And now Absolute Legends, everyone's TPing back to base. Tier 4 tower's been brought down by the creep wave. And that's all no time to want. Aegis isn't there. Sony gonna try and force a bottom racks. Even with God Strength, I know he can do this. There's no reason why he can't. The fortification, he holds off on the God Strength. And no Tidehunter. They either go for the bottom racks, which is exactly where they should be heading right now. And there's the pullback. Glimpse? Who went back? Who went back? Oh my lord! Sony went back. He tried to be pulled back out by the Wisp. He's got no TP. He'll have to go for the counter racks. In fact, he's going for the GG. He's going in for the tier 4 towers. I do not know how successful this is going to be. No Tidehunter was going to do the same. Tier 4 tower focus. Blink in, Mania, gotta stall him up. Tanks up one, Chronosphere going out on Bamboo. How's the progression looking? They're through the tier fours. They're going on the throne. There's no fortification. First TP comes back. There's still tier 4 towers. You are not gonna do this. You are not gonna do this, AL. Sony, he's still beating through. Aki buys back. He keeps on beating down. Ice, they gotta focus, come with me. The Rags S4 is here. Sony will, the buyback is there. Maybe enough, they're holding on. Buyback by everybody, they at least forced them back. The fortress is almost gone. I'm hearing a Wisp TP, he has to come back. Ice with me goes down, but they hold the line. In fact, they do more damage to the fortress than no Tidehunter was capable of doing. Amazing play from Absolute Legends, the balls deep maneuver. They still didn't take the proper racks. Melee Rax is alive on the bottom. Tide's dead for the mobile. When he respawns, he should have. Don't get caught out, Freezer. Is he doing what I think he's doing? He's going for a backdoor. He's going for a backdoor. Freezer is heading for the backdoor. He's got BT so he can return. Sony, by his full heart. He has no teleportation. They're jumping in for the back door. There's no fortification for the Radiant side. Loader is here. Tide is back with a Ravage on cooldown for one more second. Pick up, slow down, stop them for the moment. Ravage to pop, Puck is here. Got to get that silence, got to get everything else out. But BKB from Bounty Gun doesn't care. Freezer is here as well. Bambooey is just distraction. But look who's in, S4 just pushing Sony away. The stun is there, S4 wants the GG. Sony, he is going to do it. 900, 800, not enough. S4 is delaying him. It's going to be enough, 400, he's not there. The rush is what was not enough. Mag pushes him back out of range of the fortress. It would have been enough for us. Vander GG the entire bloody thing. Oh, man. Komi also pointing out one of the bugs during that. I wasn't going to comment it during it. I don't know if you noticed, but he got sent back in. He didn't mean to die that second time, but he bought back instantly so he can be part of the fight, but it's ulti. Sent him back to that position. It didn't reset out. But an amazing end to the game, an amazing end to the night. Thanks for watching, guys. Been having ourselves a great time here for the Star Ladder Season 4 coverage. I hope you've enjoyed it. We'll be back again tomorrow night. Maybe not all the games tomorrow night because we've got to rest up for DreamHack. But yeah, we are looking at some fun games tomorrow evening. I don't even know what's in the schedule. But Talk Dota will be tomorrow night. It will be tomorrow night coming up at 22 CEST. So we'll be doing that show before we hit DreamHack. And of course, it will be a DreamHack special. So stick around for that one. If you want to shoot it in, we'll be there for 22 CEST. Tomorrow, though, I believe, starts at 17 or 18 CET. So keep your eyes peeled on joindota.com for all those details. Thanks for watching, guys. Hope you've enjoyed the broadcast. And I'll see you all tomorrow.